Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 249.
Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on Tuesday clarified in Rajya Sabha that the government is now considering a ban of cryptocurrency advertisements and that a bill will be introduced in Parliament after the Cabinet approval. Apple has also released a scam warning for the users concerning the Apple gift cards. If someone approaches the user to use the codes for any payment other than the purchase of Apple goods and services, it is like a scam, and the user must report such incident to the local authorities. Oppo's first foldable may come with an 18-inch inner display with a 120Hz refresh rate. A Qualcomm Snapdragon triplet processor may power the foldable phone. Rumors suggest that this foldable phone may launch on the next month. Oppo is going to launch a couple of true wireless earbuds in India soon. Oppo Enco Free 2 and Oppo Enco Air Lite has been spotted on the Indian version of the Hey Melody application. Moto Edge X30 is expected to come with a 60-megapixel camera on the front. It is going to be powered by the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. It could come with a 6.67-inch Full HD Plus OLED panel with a 144Hz refresh rate. Redmi K50 series tipped to include 4 smartphone models in total. These devices are expected to come with an MIUI 13 out of the box. The Redmi K50 Gaming Edition is expected to debut in India as the Poco F4 GT next year. Xiaomi recently unveiled its Redmi Note 11 series in China. This lineup consists of several models, out of which Redmi Note 11 Pro Indian variant has been today spotted on the IMEI database. This IMEI listing suggests an imminent launch of the device in India. Redmi Note 11T 5G price in India starts from ₹16,999. The key specifications include a 90Hz display, MediaTek Dimensity 810 processor and a 50MP primary camera. Redmi Note 11T 5G will go on sale from December 7th. Xiaomi phone with the 120W fast charging to launch in India before the end of this year. This phone could either be the Xiaomi 11T Pro or Xiaomi 11i Hypercharge. Xiaomi 11T Pro has appeared on BIS certification with the model number BM58. Samsung Galaxy S22 will sport a triple camera setup featuring a 50MP primary sensor, a 12MP ultra-wide camera and a 10MP telephoto camera. The Samsung's upcoming S22 lineup has also been rumored to ship with an upcoming Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor in India. The regular version of the Samsung's upcoming flagship is expected to sport a 6-inch display, while this Plus model could feature a 6.55-inch screen according to the leaks. Samsung's new modem future models will be able to connect to 5G networks and enjoy download speeds up to 5.1 gigabits. The Exynos Auto T5123 is the first 5G modem designed specifically for automotive use and is already being mass-produced. Samsung Galaxy A13 4G live images from the production line have been revealed. These images suggest quad rear cameras, a 3.5mm audio jack and a USB Type-C port. This handset is expected to launch in India soon and will be a budget offering. Renault Airfoil debuts as concept flying machine shaped like a classic car. Renault plans to use 90,000 mAh of batteries that provide a maximum speed of 58 miles per hour to the Airfoil flying car. The maximum flight height would be around 700 meters. Realme is prepping up for the Realme 9 series for India. The lineup is likely to comprise 4 models such as Realme 9i, Realme 9 Pro and Realme 9 Pro Plus. Ahead of the expected early 2022 launch, the Realme 9 Pro Plus has bagged BIS certification in India. Google Play announced its Best of 2021 list on Monday with the breakdown of the top apps and games for tablets, wearOS and Google TV. Google Play made its choices based on celebrating apps and games that made positive contribution to culture this year with Balance. A personalized meditation and sleep program crowned the best app of 2021. Pokemon Unite took the top spot for the games category. Google Play users also made selections for their favorite app and games of the year, selecting Paramount Plus as a user's choice app and Garena Free Fire Max as a user's choice game. Coolpad, a Chinese smartphone manufacturer, is set to debut the Cool 20 Pro smartphone on December 1st. The brand has previously issued a teaser poster that provided us a glimpse of the sleek smartphone design. The company has recently produced a new teaser poster on Weibo, confirming that the handset would be powered by a MediaTek Dimensity 900 5G processor. Garena has announced another Free Fire crossover with the Netflix Money Heist. The new crossover event is called as Free Fire Episode Raid and Run, and it will feature the professor from Money Heist. The limited time Free Fire event will come with Money Heist themed skins, UI game mode and in-game items and many more. Tata Motors seems to have big plans for the Indian electric vehicle market. The company already accounts for a major market share in the electric vehicle sector with the Nexon EV, and now the company is all set to expand its portfolio by launching over 10 more electric vehicles in India. The Tata Motors' current electric vehicle lineup includes a popular Tata Nexon Compact XUV and a Tata Tiago hatchback. Now the company is expected to launch multiple electric vehicle models by 2026. This model includes the electric vehicle variants of the existing petrol diesel cars such as Tata Safari and Tata Harrier.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.